Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_00_023_DIAB_I where you save it. Click the File tab, hover the mouse cursor to save as and click Projects. This will bring the Save Project as dialog box. Rename this project to 00_024_DIAB_I and click the Save button. In the last tutorial, we designed the soffit of the roof. In this tutorial, we're going to model the ceiling of the roof. Click the plus sign to collapse the floor plan. And to the ceiling section, double click the ground floor plan. Now you have two methods of drawing a ceiling plan. You can either sketch the ceiling plan, or you can place a ceiling plan when the ceiling plan finds a close boundary. Go to the architectural tab and select the ceiling plan command. You have the automatic ceiling and the select the sketch ceiling. Let's start with the automatic ceiling. When you use the automatic ceiling, Revit create an automatic ceiling when you found a bounded area. Go to the property palette and click the edit type. The ceiling thickness is 2¼. Let's accept the default thickness. Click OK. Change the height from offset to 9'6" and move the mouse cursor into this area. Click to place the ceiling. Click. Now let's use the sketch ceiling command and select the pick line button. Pick this line, this wall, and this wall. Select the trim extend to corner button. Trim this sketch line. Select this sketch line. Click on join. Select this sketch line. Click the modify button. Select this line. Click this bubble and move it out. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. Click the green check mark. In the ceiling section, go to the first floor plan. Go to the architectural tab and select the ceiling command. Click into this room, this area. Click the modify button. Now go to the default 3D view. Select the roof. Click the sunglass icon and select hide category. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to see how your ceiling works. Click the front view of the view cube. Click into this area and select all the wall in the first floor. Click the sunglasses and select hide elements. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button. Select this slab. Click the sunglass hide elements to verify the ceiling in this area. So we need to edit this ceiling. Select the front ceiling and click edit boundary. Select the pick line command. Pick the face of this wall and pick the face of this wall. Click the trim extend to corner. Trim. Click the green check mark. Select the ceiling to see the results. Now we need to draw a wall from this point to the edge of the ceiling. To do that, go to the first floor plan. select the wall command, click on this area, start a wall from this point to this point, press escape, click on this wall and flip the wall to this direction. Go to the modify panel and make sure that the wall aligns to this wall. Press escape. Select the trim extend to single element and click the face of this wall. Extend this wall. Click the face of this wall and extend this wall. Press escape. Right click this section. Go to view. Select this wall. Change the base constraint to ground floor and the top constraint to first floor. Move away from the properties palette. Change the base offset to 9 feet 6. Move the mouse cursor away from the for the top offset, adjust top base and select the slab. Select the ceiling, the thickness of this ceiling. Select this ceiling and click the edit type. The thickness of this ceiling 2¼. Now select this wall again. Change this figure to 9 feet 8 space 1/4. Click the X button to close this view. Click to close this view. Close this view and see the results. Now go to the ground floor plan. Zoom in into this area. Select, right click this wall, grid similar, draw wall from this point to this point, press escape, click and flip the arrow into this direction. Go to the default 3D view, select the align command, click the face of this landing and select the face of the wall. Click the X button to close, back to the 3D, to the floor plan. Click the trim extend single element, click on this edge and extend the wall to this edge. Click the face of this wall and extend the wall to that face. Click the default 3D view, click OK. Select this wall, change the base offset to 9 feet 8¼. Go to the ground floor plan, right click this section. Go to view, zoom in into this area, use a window selection to select this wall, select the attached top base, zoom out and click the slab. Go to the default 3D view, click the ceiling and select ND edit boundary, click the pick line button and click the pick the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Go to the ground floor ceiling plan, select the trim, the pick line button and pick this line. Select the trim extend to corner, trim, 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 trim. Click the modify button, click on this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Click the green check mark. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Select this wall, change the offset to 9 feet, the base offset to 9 feet 6. Click escape to deselect the wall, select this ceiling. Click the edit boundary, zoom in into this area, or go to the ground floor ceiling plan, select the align command, align this ceiling to the face of this wall, select the face of this wall and align the ceiling, click the green check mark, go to the default 3D view to see the results. Select this ceiling, select the copy command, click the edit boundary, go to the ground floor ceiling plan. Select the align command, click the reference plane and align this ceiling. Click the green check mark. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Go to the clipboard panel, click the down arrow and select align to the same place. Click the edit boundary. Go to the ground floor ceiling plan. Click the align command. Select the edge of this wall and click the sketch line. Select the edge of this wall and click the sketch line. Select the trim extend to corner, select the sketch line, this sketch line, click the modify button, hover the mouse cursor into the sketch line and press the tab key, click, hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the default 3D view, click the green check mark to place the ceiling. click the sunglasses and select reset temporal height isolate. Go to the V cube and click the vertex between the front and the right face. Click the vertex between front, right and top face. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save command. Alright, in this tutorial, we designed the ceiling of our project. In the next tutorial, we're going to insert screw onto the port. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.